The Internet of Things is growing. Well, it's not really growing, it's exploding. But there's a problem.
Their baby monitor was actually hacked.
Did you know that DVRs were so readily hackable?
Second major cyber attack is underway right now.
In October, a botnet named Mirai shook up the internet. And what Mirai does is it pulls devices into a botnet and then points them at an unsuspecting target in what is known as a distributed denial of service attack. In the fall of last year, Mirai was used to disrupt internet service, making it difficult for many users to access popular websites like Netflix, Reddit, and Twitter. In most cases, these devices were pulled into the botnet because they use easy-to-crack or default factory passwords. So it's one thing for us maybe to have a little trouble accessing websites, but it's a whole different story when we're talking about our children.
New tonight, teddy bears hacked.
Cloud pets seems like a cute idea. They're internet-connected stuffed animals that allow relatives to share messages with children.
Just record a message.
Hope you had a good day at school. I miss you.
Hope you had a good day at school. I miss you.
In February, security researchers stumbled across a database used by Cloud Pets that was publicly exposed online. The database contained customer information, information that could be used to crack passwords, which would allow access to these stored messages. That's if customers were using weak passwords. The problem is that Cloud Pets had no password strength requirements. This allowed security researchers to figure out who was using weak passwords and gain access to the messages. And you know, if the good guys can do it, the bad guys can as well. We've decided to sacrifice security and privacy for ease and comfort, and at times, that becomes an uneasy problem. So what do we do? Well, for starters, better security protocols need to be built into these internet-connected devices. Currently, it's up to the end user to enact these security protocols, and they make these protocols difficult, if not impossible, to enact. This isn't right. It needs to be easier. It must be easier. What if the device was a brick and it didn't function until the end user walked through a specifically defined process for making the device more secure? Meanwhile, it's up to us to use strong passwords when these devices are connected. We have to do the small things to ensure that we're protecting ourselves and our internet infrastructure. It's become a fact that when these devices are correctly harnessed and pinpointed at a specific target, they can do some pretty effective damage. We're constantly uploading more of our lives up into the cloud or connecting more devices to the Internet of Things. So this isn't a problem that's going away. In fact, it's only going to be compounded. We all need to ask ourselves, does this device need to be connected to the internet? If comfort and connectivity doesn't outweigh security and privacy concerns, well then it probably doesn't need to be connected to the IoT. In the end, it's the responsibility of each and every one of us to do a couple of things. To think before we click, and to think before we connect.